Welcome to this Scriptcase Macro video. My name is Jamie Oates and I am your host. During today's macro video, we will be taking a look at the SCAPL config macro. So what is this macro all about and what can it do for us within Scriptcase? The SCAPL config macro allows us to change the state of our application without having to reconfigure the application itself, meaning we can set up our form or grid however we please, and then depending on a result, we can change how the application handles the request, or essentially is displayed to the end user. So let's take a look at this macro in action. So within Scriptcase, I already have a form and a grid application created. I am also using the samples project, which is available within Scriptcase, and we can of course generate this. So let's continue with our form. We have our form open here, and what we need to do is we need to access our events. So let's go ahead and run the form first of all, and we see we have a standard form, we have our headers, we have our quick search, and of course our form entry details. Now what we can do here is we have the option with our macro to remove the add new button, the save button, or the delete button. And we can also set the form as a new entry instead of as an edit form as it is currently. So before we go back to our form application, let's first look within the Scriptcase manual. And I should highlight the fact that we have all the information concerning this specific macro available here. We can see all of the values and how to use this specific macro. I'm not going to bother going through this because that's exactly what we will be doing within this video. So now within our form application, we can select the on application init code I have. And as we see here, I have an example of the macro sc_aplconf with the requirement of application, property, and then value. Now for form properties, we have start, insert, update, and delete. Form field properties, we have field display off and field read only. For multi-forms, as in the grid edit and multi-entry, we have rows and rows in. The value can be new, on, and off for a form overall, and also for a field, the field title. So let's have a look at this, and what we're going to do is we will first of all go ahead and run our form, and then we can see here on our form we have the typical insert edit form with an add new, save, and delete buttons. So what we're now going to do is we're going to go ahead and remove these three buttons one by one, and we are going to change the form from an edit form to only an insert. Okay, so back within our on application init, we can then paste here the first macro. So here, as indicated, Scriptcase macro to manipulate form buttons, remove, add new. Now we have here the form, which is the form title or name of this form which we are currently using, the property insert, and specifying off. So now if I go ahead and run that, the add new button will now disappear. Okay, so back here again, we can go ahead and I'm just going to skip ahead a little bit, and what I'm going to do is apply now the update and delete buttons also in one go. So here, this one here, we are removing the update button, and here we are removing the delete as indicated by the property. So if I go ahead and run that again, we will now see the remaining buttons disappear. Okay, so the final option is we want to actually go ahead and start the insert form as a new form and not as an edit. Okay, and to do that, we then indicate start and new. So let's go ahead and run that. And now the edit form will only be a new entry form. Now within our form application, we could take this one step further. And as an example, we could apply an if statement. And in this example, we have if field X equals X, then we will start with a new form. Now, of course, we can use a global variable here or any other if statement we choose to use. So now let's go have a look at the grid categories macro which we have here created, and we will be providing basically the same macro here within the events and on application init again. And now let me first paste the example again so we can see that. Okay, so again we can see here the example of this macro, and what we can do then within the grid, we again specify the grid name and we can define how many rows we want to display. So before I go ahead and run this, let me comment this out, and then we can run this and we can see that the grid has many entries. So now if I go ahead and remove the comment again, and this time we are going to indicate rows and one, we will now only have one row available within our grid. Now another option is the option to start the grid application differently. So here we can specify the start property and the value as filter. Now if I run this now, our grid will start within the filter or search mode. Thank you for watching this Scriptcase macro video. I hope you have enjoyed it. Until next time.